But first, in 1981, police received a mysterious call about a body that had been found dumped in the undergrowth by the side of a road. Now, over 40 years on, detectives are still no closer to identifying who that woman was.
August 1981, in rural North Yorkshire. The body of a woman is discovered by police.
All the police know about the woman is that she was aged about 40, 5 feet 1 or 2, with false teeth and short brown hair.
This is unusual in as much that we have no identity of the body that was found. It's rather strange as much that it is badly decomposed.
Do you have any idea how she met her death?
Unfortunately, at this stage, no.
So you're faced with an utter mystery then, aren't you?
Completely, yes.
She remained one of the more enduring mysteries for North Yorkshire police, and indeed probably for most of the north of England.
All of this happened before Adam Harland's time. But as manager of the Cold Case Review Unit, he's now in charge of the investigation.
It started back in 1981, when a call was made to Ripon Police Station by a man who describes having found a body amongst the Rose Bay Willow Herb on the road to Scorton.
The caller refused to give his details.
When he's asked why, he says it's national security. I doubt it was national security. We've never been able to trace that individual.
The anonymous caller said the body could be found on a minor road near Sutton Bank, an escarpment in the North York Moors. Officers took some time to find it in dense vegetation.
The area had to be cleared. They had to scythe away through the undergrowth to find this body and the skeleton of a female was found, but in a state of decomposition, suggesting that she had been dumped at that location.
Other evidence uncovered at the site suggested she'd been there for some time.
Underneath the body was found a yogurt pot top, which contained the date of the 6th of September 1979. That would suggest that the body had to have been placed on top of that in sometime in 1979.
That same year, a local horse rider noticed a pungent smell as he passed the spot, but he didn't report it at the time. Forty-three years on, the scene's changed. But the same questions remain.
The woods have grown up, the vegetation has changed, and it's a pretty miserable place to have your body just dumped by the side of a road somewhere. The circumstances of this lady's death point towards it being an unnatural death. We don't think she died in this location, but she's been brought to this location after her death.
She could have been from anywhere. So detectives worked with what they had, which was the skeleton.
We know that she has given birth 2 or perhaps 3 times.
The post-mortem examination revealed an unusual deformity.
Her C1 vertebra was malformed, and that meant that her skull may have sat at a slightly strange angle to the top of her neck. This is described at the time as saying that the lady might have had stooped shoulders.
In an unusual move for the time, scientists and Granada TV's makeup department were asked to help.
A wax head was made based upon the features of her skull to provide a representation of what this lady looked like in real life.
missing women were traced because of the appeal, but it didn't offer any new leads. As there seemed no chance of positively identifying the remains, 2 years after she was found, the woman was buried in the cemetery at Moulton. Twenty-eight years later, with scientific advances in DNA, the team hoped for a breakthrough.
We applied to the coroner for an exhumation, which allows us to carry out further examinations. And from that examination, we were able to establish this lady's genetic identity, her DNA. So what we have is a small improvement, perhaps, but otherwise a mystery which is now rolling on into its fifth decade.
But investigators haven't given up hope.
Here in front of us is a patch of earth where Our Lady is. It's certainly nicer than being left in the undergrowth. But you realise that for most people, they've been missed. There are people who love them, people who remembered them, and people who wanted to memorialise them. And sadly, as we stand at the moment, that's not the case with this lady. But perhaps we could do something to make sure that people knew who she was and give her a chance to be remembered.
Yeah, we really do want to find out some answers to this case. I'm joined by Cold Case Review Unit Manager Adam Harland from North Yorkshire Police. You saw him in the film there. Adam, welcome to the programme. This is a really perplexing case for you and the team. But just take us back to 1981 when the call first came in.
It's Friday the 28th of August. That's the Friday just before August bank holiday. It's 8 o'clock in the morning. It's at Ripon Police Station, and a phone call comes in from a man who we've never identified, saying that he's found human remains up near Sutton Bank in the undergrowth there. The police attend at that location, and they find there under the rosebay willow herb the remains of a female. Now, we know from investigations at the time that the body was on top of the top of a yoghurt pot, dated from 1979, and from the vegetation in the area, we know the lady has been there for at least a year, so we believe that she actually got to that location in 1979.
Now, you were provided with some information from a member of the public which corroborated these dates, didn't it?
That's right. There are, in fact, a number of people who reported a strong smell in that area, and one in particular, a local jockey out on a training ride, had noticed a smell that he thought was a fox and was intending to return that day to go and recover the brush from the fox. Unfortunately, he fell off his horse, he broke his leg, he went to hospital. Perhaps if he'd stayed on the horse a little longer, we wouldn't be here today.
Yeah, who knows? So what have you been able to find out about this woman then?
What we know about this lady is that she's between 35 and 45 years old, probably at the top end of that age range. That means she was born in the 1930s. She's about 5 foot tall, 5 foot two tall. She's got shoulder length, brown hair. She has a deformity of her neck, which means that perhaps in its severest case, her head would have been held at a peculiar angle. But for most people who have that deformity, and it is a genetic deformity, so it would run through families, it just manifests as a headache of some form or other, or perhaps as hunched shoulders. We know that she had no upper teeth, a dental plate, and very few lower teeth, 6 front lower teeth. She was a heavy smoker and she probably didn't clean her teeth very often. We also know that she'd given birth 2 or 3 times, hopefully live births, so that there are people related to her who hopefully are still alive today.
Are there any clues as to why she was found at the side of the road?
We don't know from her remains how she died. We do believe that she didn't die at that location, but she was taken there and that she was dumped. And we don't believe that was necessarily the place that the person who brought her there was intending to dump her at the time. But that's all speculation. All we really want at the moment is to know who this lady is, and that would help us move towards answering the other questions.
Well, as you said, this woman could have living relatives, and you're extremely keen to try and put all the pieces together and identify who this woman is.
Absolutely. What we have now is her DNA. That means to say that we can establish a link between her and families, if families come forward to suggest that she's missing from within their family. We know she's somebody's daughter, she's probably somebody's sister, a niece, an aunt. If her children are still alive today, she's probably a grandmother and very possibly even a great-grandmother. And we're looking for people to look at their family histories to see if there's somebody missing, either from their immediate family or perhaps from their wider family, who would fit with any of these details, so that we can go to that place in Malton Cemetery and identify who that lady is.
Adam, thank you so much. As you say, there could be so many connections. And there are some quite distinctive features about this woman, as Adam mentioned, so does any of it ring a bell? If so, then the number to call is 08000 468 999.